Okay, folks, I'm going to go through my documentary picks for Netflix. This one here, The Keepers. It is disturbing. I felt so sad. I'm a huge fan of documentaries. Always have been all my... Not so much all my life. But as I, later on, when I got older, I started really enjoying documentaries. Anyway, The Keepers really saddened me. That's my first pick. My second pick is Conversations with a Killer, Ted Bundy tapes. What really bothers me here, like, this guy was disgusting. What really bothers me here is the police had him. And this piece of garbage was able to go to the washroom, jump out a window on the second floor, and get away from the police. They had no police on him. The police had him in custody, but they let him get away, and after that, he killed several more women. And not once did I hear of any talk about how the police officers or the police precinct or whatever was never held responsible for that, because it was because of their incompetence that allowed him to continue on killing. And they should have been held in charge as well for murder because of their negligence. And but anyway, let's get on with this. This is my third pick, called The Family. It goes pretty deep into, if you really want to know or understand why the Republican Party have completely gone over to the side of worshiping Trump, it's because they see him as the Wolf King. Watch this documentary, if you do watch this documentary, you'll see how deep this actually does go, and why the Republican Party has accepted Trump as their savior. Yeah, you'll understand. This here is called Who Killed Little Gregory? Does kind of make you wonder, this particular documentary, on what happened here, but I found it really quite interesting. But like all these type of documentaries, they really sadden me. Okay, let's move on. Okay, this one here, The Sons of Sam, A Descent into Darkness. It does kind of make you wonder. I mean, when you watch this and you hear, and when you see all of the different eyewitness reports on what the killer looked like, none of them look like this guy. Not him, but him. But it is a very, very interesting, very, really quite interesting, actually. Let's move on. This one, The Confession Killer. Henry Lucas. What a bizarre piece of work this thing is. And what really gets me is that the cops who had him treated him like a star. I mean, it's mind-numbing. Anyway, really interesting to watch. Let's move on. Here you have his Room 2806, The Accusation. it doesn't matter where you live. In the United States, Canada, Australia, Britain, it doesn't matter. There are always people who are above the law, regardless. Stop feeding me stop feeding crap, all right, to people. People are not stupid. Anyway, this one is quite interesting to watch. But the rich are always above the law, which is disgusting. Anyway, let's move on. Well, if you don't know anything about how corrupt and crooked corporations are, well, this is the one to really watch. There are so many documentaries on how crooked governments, corporations, And the thing is, we're all slaves to corporations, even all the governments are. You know, slavery has never ended. Never has, never will. Not as long as corporations and governments exist. Okay, let's go on. Now, this one here is a Unabomber in his own words. To be quite honest, after I finished watching this, I went, well, that didn't really share all that many new details because I already, you know, knew the story on it. So it was like, well, it didn't shed any new light for me on what was happening. But it may for you. I just thought I would include this. The Evil Genius. Yeah, the true story of America's most diabolical bank heist. Well, you know. Starts off with a pizza delivery guy. But I have posted about this particular documentary before on my channel, but I just thought I'd put it, well, this list is my list of documentaries on Netflix, so of course it would make the list. Okay, let's go on. This one here, Carmel, or Who Killed Maria Marta. Very interesting documentary. English subtitles, but very interesting. Okay, let's continue on. This one here, The Ripper. It's about murders that, it's not The Ripper as in, you know, the late 1800s. Not that Ripper. This here is murders that took place in Britain, what, back in the 70s or something like that? Anyway, I didn't mind it. It didn't floor me as being, you know, anything super fantastic as far as the documentary is concerned. I did find it interesting. Now this one here, again, like the previous one, it didn't capture me as some documentaries do. But all the same, I watched this when I was in search of other documentaries that would interest me. And I watched it till the end. It was like, okay, this is, it was interesting. And that was about it. It's called Under Suspicion, Uncovering the West Vile Case. The West Vile Case? Don't know how to pronounce that. Okay, let's continue on. Now this one here, this is the robbery, the world's biggest art heist. I found it a little bit more entertaining. I mean, no murders or anything like that involved in this. It's just an art heist that took place. And very, very interesting as to where they may be. It's really, yeah, it is a real interesting documentary. Now this one here, Out of Thin Air. Let me see, so it's picking up after 40 years, after six were convicted of two strange murders in Iceland. This chilling documentary proves confessions can't always be trusted. Yeah, this happens to be, it was interesting to watch this and pretty much see exactly how people will convict themselves on a confession sort of thing, or have themselves convicted on a confession that, you know, the police will pound the crap out of you. Maybe not physically, but that, you know, psychologically, emotionally, they can keep you awake 36 hours, 48 hours, not even feed you. You know, it's horrendous what cops will do to you and get away with, by the way. But not saying that's what happened here. All I'm saying is that people will say, well, geez, I would never confess. Well, you're not in that position, so you don't know how you would react. But it's really quite an interesting documentary. Okay, let's continue on. Now, this particular documentary was, it was something. The Alcácer Murders, I don't even know if I'm pronouncing that right, and I highly doubt that I am. But it's really quite a documentary about three girls. It's simply a brilliant documentary. It's something worth watching. Okay, let's continue on. Here's another documentary, and I don't understand why people are so up in arms with it. Operation Varsity Blues, the college admission scandal. You know what? As far back as thousands of years ago, where higher learning has ever taken place, the rich have always bought their way in to the higher learning in colleges, whatever they may have called them back then. You know, doesn't matter if you go back 3,000 years, higher learning institutions, the rich always were able to get their kids in. You know, I mean, it's always been that way. And for people to be so shocked by this, it floors me. Because it's like, you're kidding, right? You know? I don't know why. How, you know, it's always been this way for thousands of years. How are people now looking at this going, oh, this is so disgusting. How dare you? And look, it's always been this way. I don't know why people think everything that they come across or hear about is new. There's nothing new under the sun. It's been like this for thousands of years, this thing. This. If you got the money, your child goes to school. You buy your way in. There's always someone willing to take a bribe. I mean, me personally, no, I wouldn't want that. Like, I wouldn't do that. But then again, if I saw my child having difficulty and stuff like that, you know, I'd say, I'm not going to send you to college. I'll just buy you a business. I'll put you in business. What sort of a business do you want to be? You want to be a, you know, do you want to, what sort of a business? But that's what gets me. Why are these parents putting their children through college when they are rich enough to buy a business for them? Hey, would you want to become, I don't know, you know, whatever. Oh, but I'm just surprised people are surprised by this. This has been going on for thousands of years. I just don't understand why all of a sudden they get all up in arms about it. But I don't know. Anyway, let's continue on. This one here I found very interesting. Really cool to watch, actually. How to Fix a Drug Scandal. Very, very well done. Damning evidence reveals drug lab chemist Sanja Farak. Addictions. A scandal erupts, raising questions for thousands of defendants in her cases. You know how many thousands of people were put in jail because of this woman? And not just because of this woman, because of, you know, the corruption and vanity of police officers and investigators. I mean, the whole damn system's corrupt. But anyway, very interesting documentary. Let's continue on. All right, this one here is called Amanda Knox. Very, you know, once I watched the entire thing, I was thinking, what really gets me is that you've got people, police, and people who sit there and watch, you know, these armchair detectives and say, oh, well, she's not reacting as anybody else would. Nobody reacts the same to anything. There's one thing I do happen to understand and know is that we have given birth to a society. The baby boomers have started off giving birth to a society which is now very sociopathic. The people living in this world, for the most part, are sociopathic. Not everybody, but a lot of the young are sociopathic now, who have no emotion, who have no feelings for anybody else, who only have feelings for themselves. And that's what I took away from watching this. I saw Amanda Knox as being only in for her own feelings. What's happening to me? Not, oh, poor, what happened to the girl who had this happen to her? And she's a sociopath. Amanda Knox is a sociopath who only feels for herself. She cannot feel for someone else. And that's how I see today's society. You know, if there was 1,000 people who are, say the entire world was only 1,000 people, I'd say about 800 of them are sociopathic. maybe 100 or, you know, 25 of them or psychopathic, you know, and the rest is normal human beings. But she's feeling bad for herself. She's not feeling bad for what happened to that young lady. There's no feelings for that young lady at all. That's what I picked up anyway. I mean, you're just, what you see may be totally different. Okay, let's continue on. Now, I did a small video on this one, Murder Among the Mormons. Very interesting, actually. I liked it. I didn't like what happened in it, but I do like the information that was in it. But this totally doesn't surprise me. Okay, we'll continue on. And finally, this one here, crime scene, the vanished scene at the Cecil Hotel. Very, very interesting. I felt so sad for this Elisa Lam. And her parents. I felt so sad for her. And this didn't need to happen. This did not need to happen to her. At all. But anyway, that's the documentaries I want to talk about for right now. But this is my list. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye for now.